few days ago, I came across a comment that caught my attention. To be honest, I knew about APFS DRS ammunition before creating the channel. Upon reading the comment, I thought this was very interesting and worth making a video to talk about it. So, thank you for your comment, mate. It provided me with a topic for today's video. So today, in this video, let's talk about if we can build a kind of modern smoothbore firearm by using the APFS DRS cartridge to become the new time infantry firearms. Then, in order to talk about this topic, I believe it is better to begin by exploring the APFS DRS tank ammunition. The APFS DRS is a short name for armor-piercing, fin-stabilized, escarting sabot. It's also known as the long dart penetrator or dart ammunition. According to the name, big fin is a function and appearance due to the inclusion of fins on the projectile. Most mid-battle tanks which are using this kind of ammunition have transitioned from the rifled tank gun barrel to smoothbore gun barrels. This suggests that we can potentially apply the same concept to shrieked tank guns and let regular firearms work the same way from rifled guns back to smoothbore muskets. And maybe the new type musket can have a better shooting effect. Furthermore, when discussing the APFS DRS, it is important to note another similar ammunition, the armor-piercing discarding sabot ammunition, and APDS for short. Until now, APDS is still utilized in small or medium caliber weapon systems. However, most guns that use APDS ammo, not only tank guns, but also like regular firearms, still use the rifled barrels. Nowadays, rifled guns have become the most popular firearms worldwide. However, there is still a type of gun that utilizes a smoothbore barrel. This is the modern smoothbore shotgun. We can see the modern shotgun and the specialized shells used by the shotgun as an example to explore the possibility of muskets making a comeback with dart bullets. In fact, the application of APDS or APFS DRS technology in shotgun shells should be successful, although they are not widely used. In addition, many videos and discussions about these special shotgun shells can be found online. Then, one of the reasons why this technology can be applied to shotgun might be because the 12-gauge shotgun has a larger caliber, about 0.73 inches, which is even larger than that of 0.50 caliber snap rifles. A larger caliber allows the designers to incorporate additional components like fins, sabot, or projectile with various shapes on the bullets. Apart from shotgun shells, there is another similar type of ammunition known as the sabot light armor penetrator, and SLAP, SLAP for short, which was developed by the Marine Corps in the mid to late 1980s. Meanwhile, SLAP ammunition is smaller in size, typically 0.50, 0.308, or 0.223 caliber. The noteworthy aspect is that these SLAP rounds were actually used in real combat, such as the combat of Operation Desert Storm in 1990. However, they were specifically designed for use against armored vehicles and aircraft, while the SLAP rounds actually are very similar with the regular ammunition in shape. Unlike the APFS DRS ammunition, SLAP rounds simply are still used in rifled guns. In addition, maybe due to the smaller size of a bullet, if only based on the design of a SLAP rounds, it may be hard to build a kind of dart ammo, which is similar to the tank's APFS DRS, making the projectile can have fins and other specialized additional components. In my opinion, I think this is a very good design idea, and I like this idea very much as well. Or even, it might be the future. What if this tech can cooperate with the caseless cartridge tech to form a totally new bullet? It will be possible that this kind of new bullet is able to be the best choice in the future firearm development. Because, according to the smooth bore barrel in the modern mean battle tank, the smooth bore can bring us better muscle velocity, and this means that the gun can get more accuracy and precision. But when we come back to today, what if the new type musket, especially the automatic musket by using the APF TIS rounds? These guns might have some problems. First of all, the firing rate of tank guns is much slower compared to the common automatic rifles. So with the new type guns that use the APF TIS cartridge, the firing rate gets as fast as the full auto rifles of nowadays. I don't know if it is possible that the discarded sabot can jam the gun barrel after firing too quickly and too many APF TIS cartridges. So how to ensure stability of using this kind of new cartridge, especially for the soldiers who have to battle in a very extreme and a complex field from desert to jungle. So stability becomes the first problem. And also, the cost factor should also be considered. Most of traditional bullets are kind of metal or composite shot slug. When the slug becomes a kind of dart bullet with fins, it might be more expensive and more complex in cartridge structure than the traditional bullets. So this might be the new type of a bullet would be more expensive. In addition, the weight of infantry firearm bullets is significantly lighter than that of tank bullet, which means that smaller dart bullet may be susceptible to wind interference. So its accuracy may be another issue. Plus, if the bullet was shot from the ruffled barrel, the tail part of a projectile can expand by the pressure of the instantly burning gunpowder so that the projectile can match the ruffling. Therefore, this process can make the gun have a better sealing effect. But when the lead regular firearms start to use a smooth bore barrel and APF TIS, maybe the sealing effect could be weaker. So it may take us more time to see the emergency of this new type of smooth bore firearm. Okay, this is today's video. And thank you for watching. Hope you can like this video. Have a good day. See you next time. Bye.